Ezra's standpoint. Here is a conversation, not reported in exact words, between Kayla and the contractor handling her ministry building. Contractor: Madam, the digging of the foundation is done. Kayla: That's good. Thank you, sir. Kayla goes and prays over the foundation and then begins to walk away. Contractor: So, madam, what do you want us to do to the foundation? Kayla, surprised: Sir, you are the builder and have all the details. I don't know what to tell you. Contractor: I know that, madam. I'm asking what you want to throw into the foundation before we start building on it. Kayla, now perplexed: What do you mean by that? Contractor, incredulous: I mean, do you have a sacrifice you want to bury in the foundation? Kayla, alarmed: Sacrifice? I have just prayed and invited Jesus to be the real foundation of the building. I've invited the presence of the Trinity into the foundation and the structure that will be built on it. What other sacrifice are you talking about? Contractor, still surprised: Madam, over the years, I've been contracted by many churches and other ministries to put up their ministry buildings. This is the first time I'm meeting someone who is not burying an animal or charms in the foundation of a ministry building. Many church leaders are doing it so that their church can grow and prosper. Are you sure you don't have anything to bury before we start putting up your building? Kayla, stunned: That is not what Christ taught me to do. God forbid that I should invite the devil to help me succeed in God's work. Contractor: This is a first for me. I've seen so much among Christians that I don't have any respect for Christians, churches, and their leaders. After this conversation, the contractor, a Muslim, asked his wife to join Kayla's women's ministry because he saw Kayla as a true worshiper of God and believed that she would be a very positive influence on his wife and the entire family. Colossians chapter 1 verse 13: For he has rescued us from the kingdom of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of his dear Son. Colossians 1 from verse 20 to 22: And through him God reconciled everything to himself. He made peace with everything in heaven and on earth by means of Christ's blood on the cross. This includes you who were once far away from God. You were his enemies, separated from him by your evil thoughts and actions. Yet now he has reconciled you to himself through the death of Christ in his physical body. As a result, he has brought you into his own presence, and you are holy and blameless as you stand before him without a single fault. It's hard to believe that many who have been delivered from the hands of the devil and his agents and brought into a father-children relationship with the Almighty, all-powerful King of Kings, will still go back to the same kingdom of darkness to ask for help in different areas of life, including running the ministry to which their Heavenly Father called them. One reason for this is the fear of failure, which in actual fact is the fear of Satan and his helpers. It means that these Christians believe that the devil and his cohorts are more powerful than the God who created the heavens and the earth and all that is in them. So while openly calling on the name of the Lord, they go secretly to the devil, asking for security and power to prosper. What Christians who join hands with principalities, powers, the rulers of the darkness of this world, and spiritual wickedness in the high places do not seem to realize is that by depending on these entities for help, they dishonor and shame the God of heaven, whose children and servants they claim to be. They create opportunities for the name, word, and power of God to be ridiculed. Ezra, the priest, the scribe, did not choose that path. Ezra chapter 8, from verse 21 to 23, New Living Translation: And there by the Ahava Canal, I gave orders for all of us to fast and humble ourselves before our God. We prayed that he would give us a safe journey and protect us, our children, and our goods as we traveled. For I was ashamed to ask the king for soldiers and horsemen to accompany us and protect us from enemies along the way. After all, we had told the king, our God's hand of protection is on all who worship him, but his fierce anger rages against those who abandon him. So we fasted and earnestly prayed that our God would take care of us, and he heard our prayer. Ezra understood that it would be contradictory for him to boast to King Artaxerxes about the power of the God of heaven and then approach the same king for protection instead of depending on the God about whom he had boasted. How can you enlist the help of an unbeliever in placing a ritual in the foundation of a house you are building for God and then expect that same unbeliever to give his life to a God that even you don't trust to help you succeed in the ministry to which you said he called you? How do you think you can win your co-worker to Christ after following him to his witch doctor or palm reader for help? What do you think will be the opinion of your unbelieving acquaintances about your God when you keep running to them every time you are faced with a challenge? Why should you be among those for whose sake unbelievers blaspheme and insult the name of the Lord your God? Romans chapter 2 verse 24. If you are a child of God, no matter what you are going through right now, you can be sure that God will eventually give you victory. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10. But after you have suffered for a little while, the God of all grace, who calls you to share his eternal glory in union with Christ, will himself perfect you and give you firmness, strength, and a sure foundation. That's the Good News translation. And if you truly have received a call to serve God, believe that he will back you up to ensure that you do not fail. This assurance should make you forsake Egypt and every form of help it has to offer. Throw yourself on God's mercy. Fast, pray, and let God know that you have no helper apart from him. Be like Ezra the scribe and refuse to give anyone a chance to insult your Lord. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Amen.